to the page, the YouTube page, so you'll be able to view it thereafter. What we're going to be doing again also is to record and then upload, amen, and then maybe there'll be other persons who are able to do it via their mobile phone and send it around to those who aren't able to come out today. Amen. And I'm grateful for those who have come out and you're here with us. We still haven't surpassed the prescribed amount given by our civic or civil leader. Amen. We're still within our 20 range and we're not going over in any way. Amen. Because we have to be respectful to civil leaders and those who are over us as government. Amen. I introduce to us this morning Psalm 46, Our God Who Is. Our God, under the topic, Our God Who Is. Somebody praise God. It's a well-known passage of scripture for those who aren't here. Amen. The Lord, our God, is our refuge and strength, a very present help in times of trouble. But verse 2 and 3 is very much important. He said, so we will not fear. We will not fear. Even if earthquakes come, the mountains crumble into the sea, let the oceans roar and foam, let the mountains tremble as the waters surge. A river brings joy to the city of our God, the sacred home of the Most High. Verse 5. God Himself lives in that city. It cannot be destroyed. God will protect it at the break of day. Jerusalem, I remember. My brothers and sisters, Psalm 46 has been referred to by many theologians as Martin Luther King's psalm. He said it earlier that this psalm, or this passage in particular, Martin Luther King would have used it or accustomed to use it to encourage himself and his fellow laborers when there were troubles, when it was times of darkness, when his enemies appear, when friends of Reformation were sad, Martin Luther King called for his fellow laborers and said, let us sing this psalm. Let us draw on this psalm of comfort, this psalm that brings consolation, this psalm that brings hope. Martin Luther King says, let us sing Psalm 46. Our God, when I say our God, I'm referring to the God for everyone, the God for everybody, barring none. When I talk about God, I'm talking about the Jehovah God. Yes, the Creator. Because you see, you have many other gods. Come on, G-O-D, but we are referring to the capital G-O-D, the Creator of all created things. The one who we call Jehovah. The one who sends his son, Jesus Christ, to die for us. And so, there are several names that he's been referred to as. El Shaddai, yes, El Shaddai, the God of the mountains, or God Almighty. There's a list that I sought to have established some time ago, and it is placed at a conspicuous location in my office and at home. names given to Jehovah God in the Old Testament. And I'm seeking to identify a few for some persons to understand the God that we're talking about. We're talking about the God that is called Elohim, one who refers to power and might. We're talking about Adonai, the Lord, the Lordship of our God. We're talking about Jehovah, Yahweh. Yes, that refers to the God, God's divine salvation. We talk about Jehovah Makadishim, the Lord that sanctifies. Jehovah Raha, the Lord my shepherd. Jehovah Shammah, the Lord who is present, as is referred to in the psalm. The psalm, my brothers and sisters, is addressed and it is entitled for the choir director, a psalm of the descendants of Korah, to be sung by soprano voices. So if we have any soprano voices listening or viewing, yes, this psalm is for those who have sopranos. So whatever the rhythm, whatever the note, it is mainly for sopranos. So persons like Omari and myself who sing other, we dare not try to sing this song because it is for sopranos. Sopranos. My brothers and sisters, the psalm, as we have seen it, has much as it relates to worship and praise. It says the God we worship and praise is a holy and just God who is forever faithful. The God who foresees our battles and sets provision for his faithful children. The God that I refer to is the God of heaven, the one who resides in heaven. Heaven is his throne and earth is his footstool. Somebody praise God. So as we zero in, I would have allowed you to understand that I'm seeking to present on the three main topics, three main points rather. Our God who is our refuge, our God who is our strength, and our God who is our present help. If you rather don't go three S's, you can say our God who is our shelter, our God who is our strength, and our God who is our security, sustenance, or support, whichever you want to use for the latter. But I deliberated on the first point this morning, and I spoke about our God who is our refuge. Somebody say our refuge. Our God who is our refuge, and refuge refers to that place of shelter. Yes, God is for us as a place to which we may flee for safety, is a source of strength to us in danger. The word, the first word after God is our, is refuge. And it is the refuge comes from a verb meaning to flee, and then to flee to, or to take shelter in. It denotes a place to which one would flee in a time of danger. It is as a lofty wall, a high tower, a fort, a fortress, as the commentator says. Oh, literally, refuge is a place of trust. Ah, I pointed out that Deuteronomy 33, 27 says, the eternal God is thy refuge, and underneath
and the everlasting arms, he shall thrust out the enemy from before thee, and shall say, destroy them. Somebody praise God. Ah, we allow you to understand that refuge speaks to shelter or protection. The psalmist allowed God's people to know that our God is a mighty fortress in times of trouble. Yes, he's a mighty fortress when chaos comes. He's a mighty fortress when uncertainty arises. He's a mighty fortress when our fears grow. He's a mighty fortress when problems come. He's a mighty fortress even in this time. Oh God, when there is virus and diseases, Lord God, taking all our nations, our country, Lord God, our continents and provinces, communities, streets and lanes, houses by houses, have been plagued by this deadly disease. But as Christians, we rest in the assurance that our refuge, our place of safety, our place of trust is in God. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. We know that we need not to fear, for we have a refuge, and our refuge is in the person of God. And there's a place of refuge that we can go. David said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Good God, somebody say something in here. The righteous shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Somebody praise God. Hallelujah. And then we say, our God is our strength. Oh, somebody praise God. So we are at point number two. Our God is our refuge, and he is our strength. Somebody praise God. Our strength. Say to your neighbor, our strength is in God. The word strength implies that God is the source of strength to those who are weak and defenseless. My God, somebody help me here. I said, God is our source of strength to those of us who are weak and seek to be defenseless, and even to those who may rely on his strength. Yes, God says, I am your strength. For when you are weak, then I am strong. And my grace is sufficient to keep you. I wish I had somebody who would lift your hand and say, yes, God, I know your grace is going to keep us through this trying time. Your grace is sufficient. Somebody praise Almighty God in this house. Hallelujah. And so the word strength implies that God is the source of our strength. Oh God, that we may feel safe, feel as safe in his strength as though we had that strength ourselves. We may make it the basis of our confidence as really as though the strength resided in our own arms. My God, turn with me to Psalm 18 verse 2. It said, the Lord is my rock and my fortress, my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust. Lord God, the psalmist said, my buckler and my horn of salvation, my high tower. Good God, a personal psalm, the one that is filled with nothing but my eye, a pronoun, a psalm without a pronoun that speaks to the individual, that speaks to yourself. Good God, is there somebody who's feeling helpless and hopeless? Is there somebody who's feeling low and down in your spirit? Is there somebody who's confused? Is there somebody who's troubled with some levels of uncertainty as it relates to whether or not the COVID-19 or the coronavirus or whatever we want to call it is going to invade your space? It's going to
worship you.
It's a boy.
Somebody show the hallelujah. Somebody worship the name of the Lord. But you know sometimes, listen, you don't have the sickness.
Yes,
you don't have the virus in a region, but you become weak.
Yes.
When you hear the amount that get knocked down and hit down, Lord God, you become weak. Your spirit become weak. Your body become weak. Your whole being become weak. But can I tell you something? Our God is our strength. Let somebody praise the name of the Lord. Our God is our strength, our strong tower, our fortress, our refuge. So let the storm cloud rise. But they don't worry me. Lord God, let the virus spring. But they don't worry me. But we are the anchor. Be like preaching here that keep the soul steadfast and sure. While the billows fastened to the rock that cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the spread COVID spread, spread virus spread, spread corona if you can. But listen, man, we are wrapped up, tied up in the family of Jesus. We are rooted and we are grounded. If somebody lift your hand and say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Oh yes, boy, oh glory, shout hallelujah, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I say he's our God in times of trouble. I say when trouble comes, he's our strength. God infuses us his strength. Oh, somebody praise God. I say God infuses us his strength. Turn with me to Isaiah chapter 41 and verse number 10. Lord, God, I feel a little anointing trickling on from somewhere. Somebody shout something in prison.
Hallelujah!
Oh, glory to God. Psalm 41 and verse 10. What it says, hear what it says. Isaiah 41 and verse 10, he says, don't be afraid, for I am with you, Jesus Christ. I will strengthen you, I will help you, I will uphold you with my victorious Jesus Christ. Thus saith Almighty God, to every person who's watching and listening to me, thus saith God through the psalmist, through the prophet. It's an old scripture, but it's right for today. For the anointing is resting upon me. To tell somebody, God said, don't be afraid, for I am with you, Jamaica. I am with you, Caribbean. I am with you, New Testament Church of God. I am with you, Pastor. I am with you, Brother. I am with you, Sister. I am with your family. Jesus, somebody shout hallelujah. Look at your neighbor, say, don't be afraid, for God is with you. Don't be dismayed either. Don't be discouraged. Don't be frustrated. Don't get fed up. If your boss tell you to come back tomorrow morning, if your business place closed down, if your workplace locked down, don't be dismayed. God say, I am with you. Shakuna Bashanda Rakata. For I am your God. Look at your neighbor, say, God am my God. And you never leave me. And your children shall not be to pray. So Lord God Almighty, somebody speak into the atmosphere. Somebody speak over your life. So listen to me, man, this is one close down. Operation one close down. Blood of our people. Two scriptures for the world. Isaiah 41 and Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength. Isaiah 41 is entitled God's Help for Israel. God's Help for Jamaica. Listen in silence before me, says verse 1. Your lands beyond the sea, bring your strongest arguments. Come now and speak. The court is ready for your case. Come on, love something. Virus. COVID, if you have more talk. Come on, somebody. God is ready. Somebody worship the name of the Lord. Ah, God Almighty. Hear what the verse says in the latter part of verse 10. I will uphold you with my victorious hand. God says, I will uphold you, Israel, with my what? Victorious hand. And so is he saying to us as a nation, I will uphold you with my victorious hand. You what God says, not diverting from Psalm 46, but he says in Psalm Isaiah 41 verse 11, see, look, behold, all your angry enemies lie there confused and ashamed. Anyone who opposes you will die. Jesus Christ, somebody help me here, somebody help me here. What if somebody under the anointing and the utterance and power of the Holy Ghost has a COVID virus, COVID-19, coronavirus, Lord God, whatever you name any disease, any sickness, you oppose my health, you oppose my strength, but I said to you, die. Do not be afraid, church, for God is with you in times of trouble. He said he will hide us in his pavilion, in the secret place of his Most High, Jesus Christ. Turn back with me to Joshua chapter 1 verse 9 as we try to cover and finish off with our God as our strength. Joshua chapter 1. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost. Somebody shout hallelujah. Joshua 1:9. What it says. Hear what it says. Oh God, I command you. Be strong. Joshua, I command you, be strong. So Sister Joshua and Brother Joshua, sit down before me, or stand in before me, in whichever place you are, or at whatever position you are. God said to tell you, be strong and courageous. Be not afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Look at your neighbor, say, anywhere you go, God is with you. You're going to corona bed. God is with you. You walk through contaminated, Lord God, surfaces and places. Lord God, somebody help me here.